Mapping is the process of defining relationships between dimensions of source and target applications that share data. For example, it is customary to map general ledger accounts to consolidation accounts for financial reporting purposes. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to manage mappings between the account dimensions of two different applications in Enterprise Data Management Cloud. This tutorial covers both administrator steps and user steps to map source nodes to target nodes. An administrator registers and imports the source and target applications, creates a maintenance view containing the source, target, and mapping viewpoints, creates the data map hierarchy and adds it to the view, and defines the map binding and mapping key. A data manager user maps source nodes to target nodes by updating the data map with parents from the target application and children from the source application, and then exports the mapping data. The first step for an administrator is to register and import the source and target applications and dimensions. In this example, I registered a general ledger application for an acquired company and imported the account dimension, which is the source dimension. I also registered a financial consolidation and close application and imported the account dimension, which is the target dimension. The next step for an administrator is to create a source node type for the map binding. Note, you must create at least one node type for each source dimension in the target dimension to mirror the source, because you cannot use the source node types from the source applications in the mapping viewpoint. Select the account dimension for the financial consolidation and close application. Name the node type, provide an optional description, and click Create. The next step for an administrator is to create a node type converter that converts the account node type from the acquired GL source application to the acquired account FCC node type in the financial consolidation and close target application. This allows you to map source account node types from the acquired application to target account node types in the financial consolidation and close application. Save the converter and close the inspector. The next step for an administrator is to create a map binding to map node types from the account dimension in the source application to the account dimension in the target application. Navigate to Applications and inspect the Financial Consolidation and Close application. On the Dimensions tab, click the Target Account Dimension. On the Bindings tab, click Create Map Binding. Enter a name, a description, the target node types for the map binding, and then click Create. The map binding is created along with these data chain objects. A new mapping viewpoint is created in the default view for the target application. A new node set and hierarchy set are created. The target node types that you identified when you created the map binding are added to the hierarchy set. Let's edit the child options so that when we build the data map in the maintenance view, the account node types from the FCC application will be the parents, and the account node types from the acquired application will be the children. Save the changes. Click Yes when prompted. The next step for an administrator is to create a maintenance view containing the source, target, and mapping viewpoints. Note, a maintenance view for mapping should contain viewpoints that represent both the source and target nodes to be mapped, as well as a separate mapping viewpoint where you manage the relationships between source and target nodes. I have already built a maintenance view that I can use to map accounts from the acquired company application to the financial consolidation and close application. Let's inspect the maintenance view. This view currently has two viewpoints, a FCC account viewpoint that uses the account dimension and account node set for the financial consolidation and close application, and an acquired account viewpoint that uses the account dimension and acquired account node set from the acquired GL application. Let's create a third viewpoint to maintain a data map between the acquired accounts and the financial consolidation and close accounts. Select the account dimension for the financial consolidation and close application, name the viewpoint, provide an optional description, and click Create. Edit the viewpoint and select the node set created by the map binding that we added earlier. Save the viewpoint. Close the inspector and open the maintenance view. The next step for an administrator is to create an alternate hierarchy in this viewpoint to represent the mappings between the acquired accounts and the financial accounts. Use the side-by-side layout to display the FCC account viewpoint and the account mapping viewpoint. Create a request and begin to build the hierarchy by adding a top node. Select the account node type and provide a name for the top node. Add a child of the top node. Validate and submit the request. Now that we have set up a maintenance view with a mapping viewpoint, the next step for an administrator is to bind the target viewpoint to the target dimension and define the mapping key. Inspect the Financial Consolidation and Close application. Select the account dimension. On the Bindings tab, select the binding that we created earlier. Click Edit and change the viewpoint to the account mapping FCC viewpoint we created earlier in the Financials Maintenance view, and then save. Return to the Account tab. Select the binding and select the Mapping tab. Mapping keys enable you to set up locations, which are combinations of the source and target node types that you select in order to export the mapping data. That completes the typical administration steps. Now let's look at the steps typically performed by a data manager user. Open the Financials Maintenance view and create a request. First, we'll add a target node to the account mappings hierarchy. Search for the FCCS account receivable node in the FCC account viewpoint, and then select the node in the search list to display it in the FCC account viewpoint. Drag the node to add it as a child of assets. Select Node Only when prompted. Once you have added Financial Consolidation and Close parent nodes, continue the process to add child nodes for the acquired accounts that you want to map by adding nodes from the acquired account viewpoint to the account mapping viewpoint. As defined in the hierarchy set for this viewpoint, the parent nodes are the Financial Consolidation and Close target account nodes, and the child nodes are the acquired source account nodes. When you complete your mappings, validate and submit the request, and close the view. The last step for a user is to export the mapping data. For the Financial Consolidation and Close application, select Export Mapping from the Actions menu. Select the dimension to export mappings. In this example, there is only one account. Select the location you defined in the mapping key. Choose whether to export to a file or connection. If you select connection, you must be connected to a live Financial Consolidation and Close system. In this example, I'll export to a file. You can change the file name if desired. Click Export to export the account dimension mappings. The export results are visible in the file. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.